The National Development Council is charged with the responsibility of providing guidelines to the Planning Commission. The detailed work on planning can be undertaken only when you have given the indications. I should like to emphasize at this stage that we are not concerned with the details of the plan in this meeting, but only with the basic approach to the plan. Of course, this is just as important because it limits the plan itself to some extent. The major issues are the overall goals which we seek, the tempo and pattern of development, the national effort, discipline, cooperation and determination required for reaching the set goals. We have, for instance, to address ourselves to the problem of the rate of growth. Do we consider it adequate or do we think that it should be less or more? If we think that a rate of 5% or 6% is essential, are we prepared to make the necessary effort in terms of mobilization of resources? Despite the progress registered in many directions, the broad fact remains that the real income per head is exceedingly low. Growth has not made a significant impact on the living standards of the people and has not provided opportunities for full employment or for reducing differences. That is why the rate of growth in the future is a matter of crucial importance. Planning for a 6% growth of the economy in conditions of diminishing external aid is a bold undertaking. Are we prepared to undertake it? Is there the national will for this? On the other hand, can we possibly do less? Our efforts necessarily must be vigorous. We need, therefore, a firm direction, a longer vision, and commitment to action. The National Development Council is the supreme body of our nation and can give this lead and impart this confidence to our people. The right policies and programs must be backed by the necessary resources, physical as well as financial. If we aim at having a buffer stock of food grains, it has to be financed as a part of the program of price stability. There must be development and promotion of agriculture. Increased credit facilities should be given to the weaker sections of the farming community. Facilities in regard to roads, transport and communications will have to be expanded. Basic industries will also have to be expanded to promote a rapid growth of industry. I am sure the members of the council will give serious thought to this problem of resource mobilization. We cannot talk of progressive elimination of PL 480 grain imports and the reduction of foreign aid without devising ways and means to raise the necessary additional resources. A large part of the annual increases in income will accrue in the rural sector, particularly amongst the prosperous farmers who will benefit by the developmental effort. It is evident that the mobilization of resources must take full cognizance of this fact. Our attitude in this matter should cease to be equivocal. Another range of problem to which the Planning Commission has drawn attention is related to the operation of a mixed economy. A number of questions arise. What combination of market forces and administrative directions is most suitable for resource allocation? What role should be assigned to the public sector and how can it be made important and effective? How do we encourage private enterprise without concentration of wealth and economic power? The Planning Commission has tried to strike a balance between the various sectors and has made proposals for consideration. In this respect, again, we must provide a clear lead and guidance. Dear Sir, we are glad to learn from your letter of the 5th June 1975 that you are interested in the purchase of a new furniture. We have much pleasure in enclosing a copy of our illustrated catalogue, which we trust will be of interest to you. You will see that our special exchange system extends a helping hand to all prospective purchasers of a new furniture. In other words, we are willing to value and take away your old furniture, allowing its worth against the new. We shall be pleased to open an account with you and to allow you the normal credit facilities. On the other hand, should you require purchase under our simple and economic hire purchase system, the value of your old furniture will also be accepted as all or part of your deposit. We are at the moment holding large stocks of kitchen furniture, including kitchen tables with heat resisting tops in all colors as illustrated and detailed in our catalog herewith sent. We have chairs in cheerful colors to match these tables for 25 rupees. We stock all well-known brands of kitchen cabinets and popular sink units. You are invited to visit our showrooms and examine our excellent collection of kitchen equipment, but should distance prevent you from calling, we shall be pleased to send you any item of furniture on approval to enable you to view the quality of our productions. Yours faithfully.